Hey guys, Juan here, and today I want to share with you another 10 tips and tricks for the Google Home. So let's get started. Number one, turn TV on and off using a Chromecast. If you have a Chromecast connected to your TV, you can now use it with your Google Home to turn the TV on and off. Now, for this feature to work, your TV must support HDMI CEC. Also, you want to have the Chromecast connected to an electrical outlet instead of a USB connection on the back of the TV, so like that when the TV is off, the Chromecast is still on and you're able to send a command to the Chromecast to turn on the TV. Otherwise, it's not going to work. Number two, multiple commands at once. Not too long ago, Google quietly released this update allowing to say two commands in one single interaction. So you can now say, for example, "Hey Google, turn on Leave It On Lights" and "Turn on Leave It On TV." Or, for example, "Hey Google, play Linkin Park from Spotify and set volume to 50%. You can also pair two commands together using shortcuts and create a simple phrase that would trigger those commands. Alright, number three, set up audio groups. With audio groups, you can play music or any other audio content on multiple Google Homes at the same time. To set up a group, open the Home app, tap on Devices, and open the menu for one of the speakers that you would like to set up, and then select Create Group. Now set up a name and choose the speakers that you want on the group and then tap on Save. After the setup is done, the new group will show up in the Devices tab. Whenever you want to play something on the new group, you can simply say "OK Google" plus the content that you want to play and then the name of the home group that you create. For example, "OK Google, play the latest news on home group," and it will start playing on that group that we just created. Number four, change the assistant voice. At the time of this video, if you live in the US, you're able to change the default female voice to a male voice. To do it, you can simply ask Google, "Hey Google, change your voice," and pretty much it will play a little preview of how the male voice sounds, and then it would ask you to confirm if you want to change. The other way is via the Home app. When you open the app, tap on the menu icon, then go into More Settings, Preferences, and Assistant Voice. Here you have Voice 1, which is the female voice, and Voice 2, which is the male voice. If you click on the speaker icon on the right, you can hear a preview of how each voice sounds. Something to have in mind though, that once you change the assistant voice in the Google Home, it would also change it on your mobile device. Number 5, Night Mode. Night Mode is one of the number one features that you want to enable on a new Google Home. Night Mode allows you to set up a schedule to automatically control the volume level and the LED's brightness on your Google Home. To set it up, open the Home app, then go into Devices, tap on the menu icon for one of the speakers, and then Settings. Scroll down and tap Enable Night Mode, then set up the time and days that Night Mode will be activated. Lastly, set up the maximum volume levels and the brightness that you would like for the nighttime. Have in mind that if you have multiple Google Homes, you will need to repeat the steps for each individual Google Home. Number 6. Use Google Home to broadcast messages. The broadcast feature in the Google Home is one of my favorite features. If you have multiple Google Homes, you can now ask Google to relay a message for you, and it will play that message on all the Google Homes that are connected on the same Wi-Fi. Now, you can also use the Google Assistant on your phone to relay a message, and you don't need to be connected on the same Wi-Fi. To learn more about broadcast, you can check out my previous video. You can find a link up here and also in the description below. Number 7. Sleep timers. If you're like me, you probably like to go to sleep listening to soft music. And now with the Google Home, it makes it very easy to just fire up a playlist. Now, instead of leaving the music playing all night, you can ask Google to set up a sleep timer. There are multiple ways to set up a sleep timer. If the music is already playing, for example, you can say, "Hey Google, set up a sleep timer for 30 minutes or stop playing music at 2 o'clock, for example. Now, the other way is when you're going to set up the music to play, you can say, "Hey Google, play jazz music until 2 o'clock or play it for 30 minutes, and it pretty much follows that path. Now, if you want to cancel the sleep timer, you can simply just say, "Hey Google, cancel the sleep timer," and it will cancel the sleep timer. Number 8, set up guest mode. Guest mode allows visitors to connect to your Google Home and share their favorite media without having to be connected to your home Wi-Fi connection. Now, to enable guest mode, open the Home app on your device, then go into Devices, open the menu for the home speaker that you would like to set up, tap on Guest Mode and switch it on. Now, your guest can open a Chromecast-enabled app and tap on the cast icon and select Nearby Devices. When the device tries to connect, Google Home will automatically transfer a 4-digit PIN using a short audio tone. If that fails, the person attempting to join will be asked to enter a 4-digit PIN, which can be found on the Home app on your device. Number 9. Find My Phone. This is one of the features that my wife likes. Every time she can't find her phone, Google Home is always there to help her find it. Now, to use this feature, you can quickly ask Google, "Hey Google, find my phone," and the Google Assistant will play a loud sound on your phone, even if your phone is in Do Not Disturb. Now, for this feature to work, anyone that wants to use it needs to have their Google account and their voice linked to the Google Home, otherwise it's not going to work. Number 10, reminders. There are two types of reminders that you can use. For example, you can ask Google Home to remind you to do something on a specific day at a specific time. And then when that date and time comes, you will get a reminder notification on your phone, and also the Google Home will say that it has a reminder available for you, and one of the LED lights on the Google Home will stay on until you listen to your reminder. Another way of using reminders is that you can have Google Home remember where you left things. For example, you can say, "Hey Google, remember that I left my spare keys in a white envelope in my desk." And then the next time you're looking for those keys, you can say, "Hey Google, where are my spare keys?" And then Google will tell you where they are. Alright guys, those were another 10 tips and tricks for the Google Home. If you guys haven't watched my previous 10 tips, you can find a link up here and also in the description below. Thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already, and I will see you in the next video.